Joining me here in his home state, Congressman James Clyburn, who is the number three Democrat in the U.S. House of Representatives. Thank you so much for being here.
Well, thanks for having me.
Dissect last night's results for us.
Well, I think we had two things converging at the same time. You had Mr. Romney, who seemed not to be able to connect at all with his base, really separating himself from voters. He did so in those debates. It was very clear to me that he was cutting himself off from middle income. Well, he did not deal with the so-called 15% income tax rate. He was not doing well with identifying with just ordinary voters. He just can't seem to be able to do that. While at the same time, Newt Gingrich is really throwing red meat to the base, saying little words and phrases that we are very familiar with here in the South, and identifying himself as a congressman from Georgia. So all of that helped him.
Region helped.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So when you say using words, explain that to me, because there has been a lot of talk, especially from African-Americans, saying that there are some code words that Newt Gingrich uses, and the implication is that they're racist in nature.
Well, I would say it's appealing to the Tea Party element when you say Barack Obama is the best food stamp president we've ever had. That limits his presidency to a element of dependency.
Well, it's a campaign, and he's making the point that food stamps have gone up and jobs have gone down. I mean, is that necessarily a sort of a racist comment?
Well, it's not necessarily so, but a welfare queen being uttered by Ronald Reagan is not necessarily a comment of dependency, but people know what that means. Richard Nixon, a Southern strategy. Now, all of this carries certain connotations that people know very, very well. And I think that he practiced that perfectly.
So do you think Newt Gingrich, you served in the House with him.
Absolutely.
So are you saying you think he's a racist?
No, I never use that word. And I don't ever call anybody anything that resembles that.
So you're saying?
But I'm saying that he's appealing to an element in his party that will see President Obama as different from all other presidents that we have had.
It's being African-American.
There is only one thing that makes him different from all the other presidents that we've had.
Who's the tougher opponent, do you think, for President Obama?
Oh, I have no idea. I think anybody's going to be tough. We live in a tough environment. The country is at a place it's really never been before, even if we go back to 1929. The things were different then. What happened in this country didn't affect the rest of the world. And what happened in Europe and Asia did not affect us. Today, everything is so global. This country has never been where it is before.
You represent a state, a portion of the state, that has a 9.9% unemployment rate. Nationwide, unemployment among African Americans, 15.8%. Among whites, 7.5%. When you go back to your district, as you will, I'm sure, sometime this year, to appeal for President Obama's reelection, how do you sell those kind of numbers in your district, which is majority African American?
Well, I remind them of where we were 90 days in the run-up to President Obama's being sworn in. We jettisoned 2.1 million jobs in 3 months. This was done before Barack Obama was ever sworn into office. Remember, and I will remind them, that in September of 2008, when this economy was crashing down, George Bush was president, not Obama. McCain and Obama jettisoned their campaigns, came back to Washington to help us try to pass some emergency measures to stop the hemorrhaging. And this president stopped the hemorrhaging, and for the last 22 months, we've been having private sector job growth. And if we should continue, I think he'll get us to where we ought to be.
I want to show you another figure that we had in a poll, and the question was, has the government paid enough, too much, or about right attention to the needs of blacks and other minorities? Among blacks, 77% say the government has not paid enough attention to the needs of African Americans and other minorities. You still have, under the first African American president, 3 years into his presidency, a unemployment rate twice that of whites. Is that a hard sell for you? Can you explain that?
No, we don't still have that. We are there in some instances for the first time. The fact of the matter is unemployment for African Americans started to go up dramatically during the Bush administration. It went down dramatically during the Clinton administration. And so all we will say to people is this: let's get real here. You cannot expect 3 years of President Obama to correct 3 decades, and we know it's been 3 decades because GEO has given us a study. Over the last 3 decades, we have seen growth in household income for the lower 20% of only 16% and the upper 20% of 65%, and a 275% growth for the upper 1%. So I will remind people is that this president is trying to reverse something that took place over 30 years ago and bring it into check.
I need a one-number answer from you. Scale of 1 to 10, how tough is this reelection bid for President Obama?
Or is tough, 10 the toughest?
10 is the toughest.
Or it's 10.
Congressman James Clyburn, thanks so much for joining us. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.